हरिओम चिल्ड्रेन,
टुडे आई विल टीच यू चैप्टर टू न्यूट्रिशन इन एनिमल्स ऑफ साइंस। आई एम सुतापा बिस्वास। आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू दिस पार्ट। दिस इज द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। इन चैप्टर वन यू हैव लर्न्ड व्हाट इज द न्यूट्रिशन। What is nutrition? The process of taking food by an organism as well as the utilization of the food by the organism is called nutrition. Then what is animal nutrition? You will write the process of taking in food by an animal and its utilization in the body is called nutrition in animals. Just in the place of organism you will write animal, okay? So in first chapter you have learned that nutrition are of two types, that is known as modes of nutrition, the methods of obtaining food. What are the two types? Autotrophs and heterotrophs. And heterotrophs again are divided into holozoic nutrition, parasitic nutrition and saprophytic nutrition. But in animal nutrition we can see only there are two types of nutrition, holozoic nutrition and parasitic nutrition. Except some animals, no animals have chlorophyll, so they cannot make their own food. So they are not autotrophs, they obtain their food from another organism, that's why they are known as heterotrophs. All animals are heterotrophs. They take in complex materials as food and break it down into simpler forms. So nutrition in animals are of two types, holozoic nutrition and parasitic nutrition. What is holozoic nutrition? All animals and humans eat food in solid or liquid state. This ingested food is then digested in the alimentary canal. This is holozoic type of nutrition. And parasitic nutrition, as you know, the nutrition that animals derive from the body of other living organism is called parasitic nutrition. In animal, what are the examples in animals? You will give the example of mosquito and lice who suck blood of animals. Tapeworm and roundworm live inside our intestine and take digested food from humans' intestine. Understood? Here, first of all, in nutrition, you will learn about ingestion. Ingestion, the nutrition can be performed into two steps, ingestion and digestion. What is ingestion? Ingestion, the animals in which way they take food inside their mouth or inside their body, that is known as ingestion. The animals intake food by different method. For example, animals use just like amoeba, they engulf food. I will teach you later. Animals use different methods for ingestion of food. Have you seen the butterfly, the honeybee to suck nectar from the flower with their proboscis? Hydra have tentacles. They catches prey with the help of tentacles. Here you can see a frog catching prey. Lizard, frog, chameleon have long and sticky tongue. The prey when sit on their tongue, to catch the prey, they give out their tongue from the mouth and the insect get stuck on the tongue. After that they take the food through the tongue inside their mouth. here I have told you how the butterfly take the nectar, butterflies take nectar, honeybees take nectar with a mouth parts that is known as proboscis. Okay, here feeding tube or proboscis. Here you can see eagle catch their prey with the help of their long sharp and claws and with their beak. In this way you can see that different animals catch their prey or their food with in different methods. This is called an intake the food inside their mouth or inside their body through different method. This method is called ingestion. Number two step of nutrition, taking nutrition inside the body. Number two is digestion. What is digestion? The breakdown of complex components of food into simpler substance is called digestion. These components which we eat as carbohydrate, protein, fat, these are broken into small simpler substance. Just that protein changes into amino acid, carbohydrate changes into glucose, and fat changes into fatty acid after the digestion. So that they are simpler substance, so that our body can absorb this substance inside our body. These nutrients can be absorbed by our body. Understood? So in human being, I will explain it later how the digestion occurs in human being. Here you can see the larger molecules, okay, which is broken after digestion by taking the energy into smaller molecules. This is digestion. Methods for digestion are two types: physical method and chemical method. Physical method, which physical means which we can see. Physical methods includes grinding, chewing the food in mouth. And chemical methods include the addition of digestive juices or enzymes. What is the other name of digestive juice? Enzymes. They are secreted through our some digestive organ. Okay, they digest the food. That means digest means to they break down the higher molecule into simpler complex molecule into simpler form to food by the body itself. These juices are secreted by the body itself, specifically from the digestive organ. Understood? And three glands are associated with the digestion. In human being, you can say salivary glands, liver and pancreas are associated with digestion. So glands secrete juices, okay, they also help in digestion. Here is the another topic, alimentary canal. What is alimentary canal? A long tube running from mouth to anus in which digestion and absorption of food is called alimentary canal. Food passed through it by the process of peristalsis. Peristalsis is one type of movement of our alimentary canal. Okay, here one part is relaxed and another part is contract. In this way the food will go forward. This movement is called peristalsis movement. In alimentary canal consists of many organs: esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum and anus. this is the steps or something introduction of digestion. Okay, in next chapter I will teach you the digestion in human being. Till now this only. Bye and thank you.